I'm going to go out on a limb here, okay? If we say, well, why should you grow important grow Zinfandel? You could grow Zinfandel because it's important to do it because it's a continuation of our heritage. It's our contribution to the heritage, okay? Isn't it somewhat a saying that rent control in San Francisco, right? We can't take the 85-year-old woman who's still paying $500 and rent your rent to $3,000. That's what the law is, but it is also the right thing to do, right? That this woman needs to keep her place to live, right? So maybe we have a community responsibility to promote Zinfandel and to keep growing it, to preserve and continue. That might probably be pretty important there, right? We don't want to just preserve it as if we lock it up in a museum someplace. We want to still keep on moving it forward and learning more about it and doing a better and better and better and better job. Maybe some people should be thinking that as in service to the industry that brought that in service to the heritage that allowed them to have a winery in California in the first place, right? Maybe say, well, you probably wouldn't have had this vibrant of a wine industry if you didn't have Zinfandel in the first place, 150 years ago, in order to really bring California wine to prominence. And, you know, something we ought to just be paying attention to. Maybe we ought to figure out a way to get people to pay more money for it. Maybe we need to do a better job in marketing Zinfandel and say, I don't know why you're willing to pay $100 for a bottle of Cabernet, but you won't pay $50 for a bottle of Zinfandel. If we could solve that nut. So I'm going to put it on the winemaker side, the marketer's side. If the marketers can get more money for the wine, then we will see an uprising in Zinfandel plantings.